I have no guilt about my 5 top quilts. I have a reason.
There's one for every season.
One I can wear if I dare.
One is a top quilt and underquilt. Oh, it is so well built.
Different colors, different styles. Watch me as I lay a while. All of mine are filled but down. I'm gonna tell you, this is one warm clown.
So I've come to learn lately that a lot of people don't know what a top quilt is. What is a top quilt?
Top quilt is really just a sleeping bag without a zipper or a hood.
They're great in a hammock. You know, you lay in there and tuck them in around you. Normally you have an underquilt on the outside of your hammock that really functions as the part of a sleeping bag that would be under you when you're laying on the ground. And of course, most people know when you compress down, if you're using a down sleeping bag, the down gets compressed, thereby not, you know, insulating you as well. And on the ground, that's a moot point because you're laying on a pad. In a hammock, unless you have a pad in there with you, your underquilt is going to act as that part. You save a little bit of weight by not having the zipper and the hood. And you also don't have that down material that is taken away. And that comes in really handy for people that are ultra lightweight and like to sleep with a top quilt on the ground with a lightweight pad in the most lightweight fashion possible. In a hammock, they're just great because they wrap in around you. Let's just take a look at how that is, just because really, I just want to get in there and just lay down for a minute.
Guess I don't give out. Yes, sir.
Using a sleeping bag in a hammock is just fine. You know, a lot of people still like to get in there and use the hood and zip themselves up wherever the zipper may be. You can also use a sleeping bag in a hammock and kind of just simulate a top quilt by just kind of keep your sleeping bag zipped from the foot end here, you know, about as far up as like a top quilt is. Just, you know, just above the knee, that's plenty, and the rest you tuck in around you. Every one of these top quilts I'm going to show, I'm going to put the specs and the links to where you get them, and you can check the specs yourself, but it'll be below in the description box, right below.
I slide my feet right in. You do a little thing called the tuck. There's a little draw cord right in the middle, and I can draw the top in a little bit. And that helps it wrap around my shoulders. So now I'm wrapped in here, so I'm taking this hand, my right arm, and I'm reaching across my chest, and I'm tucking in this left shoulder here. I'm doing the same thing with my left hand. And then I got my hands down right around my thighs, and I take that little bit of extra fabric and just tuck it in behind me. And because I got no underquilt or pad in here, I can definitely feel the coolness on my back. That happens in hammocks if you don't bring some kind of under insulation. It can be a pad or an underquilt. Pads work fine, almost everybody has one. Once you go under quilt, baby, I'm telling you, you ain't gonna want to go back.
There's a look at all my top quilts right there. Starting with hammock gear, 30 degree, what I call an insert top quilt, which I use in deep winter camping a lot. Inside of this, 0 degree, but this is probably actually a -5 Warbonnet Mamba. This is a hammock gear Burrow, 20 degree, custom made. For me, because it has that on it right there. This is a Jacksrbetter Hudson River top quilt and underquilt. It comes out, you can untie it on the end, and it fashions as an underquilt as well. This is a Jacksrbetter High Sierra Sniveller, rated to about 5 to 10 degrees, and it has a Velcro slit right here that you can put your head through and wear it as a serape. So those are my 5 underquilts. You know, people love to ask me whether I bought these or whether they were given to me. Well, let me tell you. The Warbonnet Mamba, I bought. The Jacksrbetter High Sierra Sniveller, given to me. That's because I've done a lot of promotion for them, so it was just a little thank you to me. The Jacksrbetter Hudson River top quilt, I bought. The Hammock Gear 20 degree custom top quilt, it was a gift from Stormcrow. I didn't ask for it, he just sent it, showed up on my doorstep. That's just the way he is. And the 30 degree Hammock Gear top quilt insert, I paid for. Well, I went by some down from him because I was going to make my own. And then Adam being Adam said, let me make it for you. So let's just say I bought it and was giving some of it.
Okay, the one I'm in right now is my Warbonnet Mamba top quilt. Now Brandon sizes his quilts if you go on his site. The regular is for people up to 5'10" tall, and the XL is for people up to 6'4" tall. This is why he sold me this years ago. It was one of his first ones. He said there's some defects in it. I can't find them. It's a very thick quilt, probably good to -5. A lot of goose down in it.
On the corners here, there's a draw cord that you can use to spread the thing all the way out. And on your regulars, at the top, it's 48" wide. And on the extra long, it's 55" at the top there. So that's kind of the look of that. They're made of 20D nylon DWR ripstop. The baffles are about 3.5" thick, so you can see right there, that is a lot of loft on that. There's my hand in comparison.
Here it is in the stuff sack. And you can still compress that down a little bit. But here we go.
They represent the lollipop gill, the lollipop gill.
There it is next to an Algene bottle. Hope you're satisfied.
So my Mamba in its stuff sack is 2 pounds, 0.3 ounces. That is 32.30 ounces. That is 914 grams. Next, we're going to look at the High Sierra Sniveller by Jacksrbetter. Mine is a regular, so it's 78" long. Okay, that is 52" at the top, and it tapers down to 42" at the foot if that was, you know, opened up. 3.5" of loft. That's 800 goose down in that. It ties at the bottom to create the foot box. You can open it up as a quilt. You could probably use this as an underquilt, but what's cool about this one is you can wear it. And there's my hand in comparison to the loft. Nice warm quilt. This is where the slit is right here. There's a Velcro slit, so you can wear this thing. We're gonna look at. And on the ends, they also have your drawstrings and cinch cords here, so you can draw that up around your shoulders. They have a snap right there, which is pretty handy to take the snap and snap it. Snap that snap, because that's what you do with snaps. And then that's real nice to have around your head when you're all tucked up in there. They also add a few loops right here if you needed to tie it off. If you like your foot box a little bit longer, you can tie off there.
So this TQ is made of a 0.9" ripstop. It's a 20D DWR, which is moisture resistant. Jacksrbetter stuff comes in pretty much this color. Hope you like green. This is probably a little bit more of an olive green, and they have the black inside, but that's kind of their signature color. They get their quilts to you very quickly. They have them in stock, so when you order from them, there's not a big turnaround time. That's a really nice thing about Jacksrbetter. And they were also one of the first companies to be making underquilts commercially. It's Jack and Jack, and they're still out there working. So let's lay in it and have a look at that. So mine is the regular, so it's 78" long. They have the XL, which is 86" long. I'm 6 feet tall, and this is plenty long for me. There's plenty of material to tuck up under me if I was ground sleeping, which is really nice. And, you know, if you go to your side in a top quilt, you got to reach around behind you and just kind of tuck it in a little bit. Let's put it in serape mode and take a look at that. And what's kind of handy about that is for somebody that's going really lightweight, you know, your top quilts usually just laying in your tent or your hammock and it's not doing anything, but this way you can actually wear it around camp. That said, be very careful if you're around a fire or any sparks. Make sure you put something on over it, because a spark will get on this material and burn a hole in no time. And you don't want to do that on your expensive top quilt. So all we do on that is I just undo the ends. It's got Velcro there, and it's kind of nice because you can just open it up.
And then your top quilt just becomes a big old quilt. Just open up this Velcro, which is right here in the middle of the top quilt. Just open that up and go ahead and just slip your head on through there. You know, and you could just wear it loose like this if you'd like. Grab the back ends, bring them around, tuck the front end in. And it comes with a small beaner hooked on it right there, which you're probably wondering about. But that's for taking one of these tabs and you can just hook that. And man, there you go. I mean, that, my friends, is a fashion statement. But of course, you know, you'd have some, if it was that cold, you'd have some warm clothes over your arms and a headgear on. You could add a hood to this. Jacksrbetter, they're one of the companies that sells these things called down sleeves. And they're actually designed to wear with something like this. It's just a down sleeve that comes about that far. This is just another great thing about the High Sierra Sniveller. The High Sierra Sniveller is it turns into a serape. So keep that in mind. If that's something that's important to you, doubles up, and it's just not sitting in your, you know, just not sitting over there doing nothing in my hammock or your tent. And the Velcro around the neck, I don't even really feel it. And then it's pretty easy just to put it back together. You just take that hook and loop, that's what they call it. It's Velcro-ish. But you just take the hook and loop, and you're gonna create your foot box again here. There's a little snap right there. And then you just take your cord on the end and cinch that down. And if you wanted to, like I do on some of mine, some people worry that there's a small gap right there. You can just kind of grab it and do a little something like this and wrap your cords and tie them off, which I often do. But you don't really have to. But if you want to, that's something you can do. I just thought I'd tell you. I never do. I am right now, so I guess I do. And you're back into your quilt mode. Now we're looking at the 20 degree Hudson River top quilt by Jacksrbetter. Very similar, same type of material. It's a 20D ripstop, uses 800 down. The end does the same thing. It ties off like that. There's Velcro right there. My particular one had a couple little lines I could tie off to keep that foot box together. Instead of snaps, you have your cord and your cinch locks on the end to draw it in. Mine is a regular, so it's 78 inches long. And at the top, it's not quite as wide. It's way more meant for a hammock. It's 48 inches across there. Uses 800 goose down. And what is really cool about this one is it becomes an underquilt, a full-length underquilt. I've used it as an underquilt before, totally works. I've had many a trip in this TQ and have never been cold in it. I'm not gonna put that in underquilt mode because I just don't feel like it. I'm too lazy, I got too many quilts to show you. And I think one of my very first underquilt videos, I showed this on a blackbird hammock. Shall we move to our next one? I'm sorry I did that to you, probably scared you a little. All right, now we're looking at my Hammock Gear Burrow, custom made. Now, Storm Crow made this for me with perpendicular baffles there, or should I say, I'm gonna call these vertical and these horizontal. So vertical baffles that way, horizontal baffles at the foot. Most of his quilts have a sewn-in foot box instead of tying off at the end. This is the reason this is a custom job, my favorite colors, plus my little logo. Right in there, he's using 850 down. If you get a Burrow, mine is a standard, so it's 74 inches long, and it's 50 inches wide at the top. And if you were to get his, what he calls long, that would be 79 inches, and still 50 inches at the top. He has a lot of sizes. You're gonna have to just go on his site and look at that. Well, he sells top quilts that are short, regular, and long, and he sells them short wide or short regular, short long or short, meaning he makes them wider for people that want to sleep on the ground with a top quilt, a little more narrow for the people that want to sleep in a hammock. Make sure to go to hammockgear.com and check the specs on all of these, because there's a lot. The other thing that Hammock Gear specializes in, they have a large array of colors. I mean, it is a swatch of colors. Also, their fabric is an argon fabric. It feels ever so good.
All right. Tuck it up under you. Cinch it up. Like that. And this way, when I sit up or sit back, it's well cinched around me. I did do a video on this once about the top quilts on the ground. I was curious myself because I've only ever used them in the hammock. And that'll probably be tagged on the end of this video. This one's got really nice loft on it.
All right, here's the loft on this, which is a 20 degree. I would say probably more even a 15 degree. And there's my hand. You can see the loft right there in the middle. So here we see it from this angle. Here's the snaps for snapping it together. He puts his cinch cord in the middle to draw it up. And the foot box is sewn from here to here, and he puts a nice gusset right there. I like this a lot. It allows you to open it up a little bit without stressing that. And but what I really like more than anything are these sewn foot boxes. This is a separate piece with down in it. It doesn't push down on your feet. Your feet just have all this joyful room in there. And what's nice, when I have my feet in there, I'm wiggling them back and forth. They got a lot of nice room. As far as underquilts go, my feet told me. Well, my left foot did. My right foot doesn't say much. You know, it's like twins. You know, if you know twins, there's always one you'd rather go out to lunch with than the other. So my left foot told me, hey man, we really like it down in that foot box. Put us there more. So I do. And this is the custom one I had Adam make. It's probably a 30 degree top quilt. Bit of a smaller foot box because I got it as an insert to put inside of another top quilt. 42 inches at the top. Horizontal baffles and made of an argon and 850 down. And what I do a lot is I put my Warbonnet Mamba -5 together with that 30 to get real low. I will insert them together right now because I know that you, maybe not you, but you for sure, are curious to see. Now I like the idea of putting top quilts or even stacking under quilts together because you get a little bit more versatility out of them. Here are the two top quilts nestled together.
And these are both meant to go in the hammock. So I'll be tucked right on in there. Man, got a lot of down on me. And of course with this, because top quilts don't have hoods, when I'm getting to these temperatures, I have my down beanie on, a balaclava. I have a down hood I put over that. Sometimes a Black Rock down beanie under that, because I carry those anyway, because the hood on your sleeping bag is doing nothing for you till you go to sleep. But I'm not making excuses for top quilts or sleeping bags. And maybe we should just throw this in the hammock and try it. Most people can really afford or only really want to buy one and see how, you know, if that's going to get them through, you know, three season. If you're gonna do four season camping, I don't know. But I think a 20 degree top quilt is probably the most versatile, depending on where you live. You can vent it if you need to, you know, just kick a leg out or whatever. If you get one of the ones that undo, you can kind of undo it a little bit easier. I kind of like having a broad range because I live in Minnesota and it gets mighty cold. The summers are warm, but I don't go in the summer a lot, but a lot of my stuff is spring and fall. So a good 20 degree works for most of the time. I use that 30 degree insert a lot more than I thought as a standalone top quilt. Hope you enjoyed looking at these. So, and also hope that if you didn't know what a top quilt was, maybe now you're probably sick of hearing me say top quilt and looking at top quilt. So mission accomplished. Always good to be able to escape quickly. All secure in Sector 7. Woo, buddy! Okay, well, I might have said earlier I was going to put them all in the stuff sacks, but I'm not. You know why? I just don't want to. In this video, we'll just go on and on and on and on and on and ad infinitum to never end. So you saw the one in a stuff sack. That was a 0 degree. And, you know, if you've got a 20 degree, it's going to be just a little smaller. 30 degree, a little smaller than that. A 0 degree, a little bigger than those. So the more down there is and the longer your quilt is, the more it's going to take up. But quilts, unlike underquilts, you can have a partial underquilt, which will pack down small. Quilts and sleeping bags, you know about the size. You know, usually generally this biggish, you know, that big to down to that big around. Well, guys, I'm kind of tired. So I'm going to go on in. I'm going to start editing this video. I hope you like looking at it. I appreciate y'all that do. Thank you.